curate your space with just the key elements that gives it the feeling that you're going for. If you guys want to know how to get big style in a small space, today's video I've got you covered. I'm going to go through 12 tips on how to get big style in a small space. If you guys are liking this content, I would really love it if you would consider subscribing to my channel, hitting the like button, and also the little bell that will notify you every time I upload a video. And just so you know, I upload a new design video every Monday. So tip number one is to use light colors or even opt for a monochromatic color scheme. What this does is light colors tend to make a room or a space feel much larger than it is. When you go with darker or heavier tones, we tend to get a closed-in space. So a way of tricking the eye, let's say you have a really long space. Now this isn't a small space, but let's say you had a really long space. What we would typically do is paint each side with a darker color to help bring it in. So you wanna do the very opposite when you have a small space. You wanna paint things light, keep things all in one color family, and what that will do is give you the illusion of more space. Another way to achieve this is painting your ceiling the same color as your walls. So not everybody likes that look, but sometimes it really helps make the space seem bigger. Also with monochromatic color schemes, you'll see this even with, you know, celebrities in certain designs. Kim Kardashian is very well known for this, but tone on tone is very flattering, not just for the figure, but also for the space that you're living in. And it will definitely help blend away some of those lines and some of those closed in spaces, which is why this technique also works very well in residential. Tip number two, you want to have as much natural light as possible. I actually did a video on how to hang curtains, and why that's really important, I'll link it up here, is that you want to make sure that when you hang your curtains, you are not covering any part of that window. You want it as far out, and I give you all the tips in that video of how to hang them properly so that you get all the natural light into your space. Along with that, you want to add some light layering, and sorry, this one's like a total plug, but I have another video on lighting, which talks about ambient lighting, task lighting, and accent lighting. And this is really important to help create the right amount of lighting in your space. And you really, in a small space, don't want to have any dark corners. You want to make sure that the space feels very bright. One of the things when you have a small space is minimalism works for this space. Now, I'm not saying get rid of all your stuff. You don't have to be like that minimalistic. However, trying to declutter and, you know, going with the less is more is really what's going to be a key element for taking a small space and making it feel bigger. When you take a small space and fill it with lots of stuff, it tends to close in the space. So what you want to do is pick some key pieces, think about placement, and what you really want to do is curate your space with just the key elements that gives it the feeling that you're going for. Tip number four, mirrors. Mirrors are gonna be your best friend. If you have a small space, take advantage of a beautiful full-length mirror. What this will do is make the space feel much larger than it is. You can use mirrors to trick the eye to create the illusion of a much larger space. Tip number five, furniture. The size of your furniture is really important. Now, just because you have a small space doesn't mean buy small furniture. It means that you need to find furniture that is the right scale for your space. So what that means is not too big and not too small. Because when you go to either extreme, you'll make the space feel like the furniture just doesn't fit. I recommend that you check out my video on the 6 principles of interior design, where I actually cover scale and proportion to help give you an idea of how to figure that out. Tip number 6, maximize height. So you really want to take advantage, no matter what height your ceilings are, but bring things all the way up to the top. So like in my curtains video, you bring them up. If you have bookcases, get them as tall as possible. What you really want to do is try to maximize that visual cue that you have a really high ceiling, even if you don't. So that's really, really important. So maximize your height within the space. Tip number 7, back to some decor items, use larger decor pieces instead of a lot of little ones. So what this does is it just helps anchor and give style to a space without cluttering a space. Clutter makes it feel small, while very curated tailor pieces, even if they're large, will make it feel more designed. Tip number 8, go for a big piece of artwork. Sounds counterintuitive, you've got a small space, but honestly, getting that one really large piece in this space will really make it feel bigger than it is. If you've got neutral colors on the walls and everything blends away, and then you have that one statement piece, really helps make a small space feel very well designed. Tip number 9, a large area rug in a small space can actually really help anchor and center a space. When you have a living room, you want your area rug to go underneath all of your pieces, and you want to make sure that it really helps define that space. Even with a small space, you want every single aspect of that space to look very well designed and very well thought out. Anchoring a space such as a living room with a beautiful, correctly sized area rug will really take it to the next level. Tip number 10, have furniture with exposed legs. So when you can see space underneath your furniture, it actually gives a more lighter feeling to the space. When you have very solid pieces that go all the way to the floor, it tends to feel more closed off and more choppy. Kind of back to that minimalism, but a thinner, sleeker leg, a bigger gap underneath, those are all things that will help make your space feel more open. It's almost like a trickery of the eye. By creating a natural empty space underneath some of your larger pieces, it actually makes them feel less large. When you have very weighted and solid pieces that go all the way down, you actually create this visual sense of more closed in and heavy. So by bringing things up, having a clear space underneath your furniture, it's what we call that white space, and you want to keep some of that untouched and clean and that openness underneath. It really helps the space feel much larger than it is. Tip number 11, use glass tops. So using glass in your space is very similar to what we just talked about in the previous tip. It helps give an illusion of more space and less bulk. So you really want to help create that visual openness to the space. And when you have a small space, you really want to make sure that it doesn't feel heavy. So using a glass piece, whether it's a glass dining room table, a glass side table, a glass coffee table, it will really help lighten up that space and not make it feel smaller than it needs to be. Tip number 12. Having furniture that has multi-purpose use. Now, this is really important if you have a small space. So making sure that you take advantage of every single square inch for storage. So using multifunctional pieces like a credenza to hold up your TV, that can be used for storage of all of your equipment and gear. Having bookcases that have, you know, doors on the bottom part that you can hide some of your extra stuff. So when you're selecting items for your space, really try to think of what you need in that space and then see if you can find pieces that can do double duty or triple duty, depending on what you find. I hope you enjoyed this video where I teach you how to take your small space and give it some big style. And if you enjoyed this content, please consider subscribing to my channel. I'd really appreciate it. Until next time, bye. We'll be right back.